Alright, so we've arrived. This place looks incredibly cool. Looks like there might be another group of people trying to explore this. We'll see if they go through the gap in the fence. Alright, we made it to Molly Stark. Abandoned hospital.
And rehab center.
We're on our way in. It's a nice day out, about 55 degrees. And this looks like it might be our way in. Maybe not. Okay, so we're up on the second floor. The lighting is a lot better up here. Things are just smashed up. The whole place has been destroyed. I have to imagine that there's been some scrappers that have come in here. This place did not always used to be guarded with that barbed wire fence. I mean, look at this. So you see all the fire damage in there. I think our first goal should be to get to the balcony.
So you a little higher too.
Yeah. Check that out back there though. Yeah.
So we can get your check out.
Look in here. You want a shower? Look at that. I need to call the nurse.
I found a patient book here. And that was one.
So you have the toilets look brand fucking new?
See, they probably tried to fix it up, but then they stopped because they realized how bad this was.
It's pretty dark though.
Yeah, the tub and shit looks brand new.
No,
where's
some stairs?
I'm gonna mask up before I go down that way. Man, it is just incredibly dark back here. Don't know how much further we really want to explore in here. It's super decrepit. On the off chance that there's something interesting back here, it might be worth it. These kids that I came in with, they went upstairs in the stairwell back a ways. It's much lighter up there. A little bit less dangerous. The asbestos and air quality. Pretty cool though, right here, I'll tell you what. The elevator there. Just look how dark it is though without my flashlight on. I mean, it's pitch black. All these rooms are empty, completely scrapped. Nothing particularly interesting in them. Wow, it's cold down here too. It's incredibly cold down here. Let's see what's in here. Okay, another staircase there. Okay, I've nearly made it to the other end of the hospital. This place is just massive. So far, the bottom floor, really not that interesting, otherwise I'd show a little bit more of it. We got a few things like this, water fountains, some hospital beds, radiators. But for the most part, it is just trashed. It's not weathered well. There's a little bit more light there. Looks like another way somebody came in, so let me just kick that through. So the kid that I came in with, he said he came back here a couple days ago and busted a hole open. Probably if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be able to be in here. There's not too much back here. All right, time to go up. Hopefully we can get to those balconies that we saw from the outside. Here we go. All right, so we're up here on the second floor. Most of the rooms go something like this. Really completely destroyed. Typically two hospital beds and a mirror. It's just really quite decrepit back here though. See the same thing over here. That's those kids that came in last. I've scared them twice now. Hopefully I don't mess with them again. That's interesting right there. Look at that, there's kids playing out over there. Just to give you perspective where we are in the building. Alright. Let's keep going forward. Most of these rooms all look the same. So I'll see you guys on the third floor. Found something interesting here. Looks like it's used for storing medicine. There's a biohazard room right next to it. Probably for sharps. Really interesting. The rust on that door, that was beautiful. That's some cool colors right there. Oh, shoot, I just found through there.
Alright. It's time for level 3. Up we go. Top level, same as the first. I was kind of hoping to be a little less destroyed. But looks like I'm out of luck. Okay, so I found a wing that's a little less destroyed. Interesting cabinetry here. Very curious what this is. Oh wow, that's pretty cool right there. My first guess is that it's an autoclave. And I think that's correct. Very cool. It's pretty old though. Okay, we made it out on the balcony. I think this was the spot I was most interested in finding coming through here. Definitely one of the most distinctive features. Oh, that bird got me. One of the most distinctive features of this building. Those beautiful columns. And beautiful 1920s architecture. Gorgeous. So the people I came in with told me there were man-sized chicken coops in here. I guess this is what they were talking about. Don't really have a clue what they were using this for.